The Dead Man Attack, as bloody and violent as it may sound. How did this story happen? Is it true or just a legend? And how did Nobel laureate invent one of the most terrible weapon types in the world? Let's try to figure it out.
This story happened in August 1915 in the midst of World War I. The battle for a Soviet fortress was underway. The Russians were fighting the Germans on the Eastern Front. And at that moment happened something that went into all history books of the world as one of the bloodiest chemical weapon attacks. German soldiers used poison gas, and most of the Russian soldiers died minutes later. However, not all, and those who didn't die instantly but who were already doomed to death desperately launched their final attack. The attacking Russians resembled real zombies. They were poisoned by a mixture of chlorine and bromine.
But were the people who were exposed to gas already dead? How does modern science explain the phenomenon of the dead man attack? Let's take a look inside and use some chemistry knowledge for it.
From our school chemistry course, we all know that the halogens in pure form, in particular chlorine and bromine, are poisonous substances. But why are these compounds so deadly to all living organisms? The answer is, although they are just diatomic molecules, pretty simple structures, they are really strong oxidizers that can damage many biomolecules. The key determinants of toxicity level are the concentration and duration of exposure of the inhaled gas. Once inhaled, chlorine gas diffuses into the moisture of the respiratory epithelium and either directly damages different biomolecules by oxidizing or hydrolyzes, it means decomposes by water to the mixture of hydrochloric and hypochlorous acids. The latter way is the most destructive and leads to the significant damage, because it's known that the free radicals formation results in the so-called oxidative stress that can lead to the cell death or even DNA damage. It's kind of double shot to all parts of our cells. Long story short, chlorine toxicity is either direct oxidation by molecular chlorine or free radicals oxidative stress, caused by the hypochlorous acid decomposition. And that's really interesting how chlorine gets through the cell membrane before it may damage DNA. Let us show you. All cells of our body tissues consist of phospholipids that make up their wall structure. And these molecules also react with HOCl and Cl2, forming unstable organic chloramines.
Thus, cell walls and membranes become destroyed. Chlorine gets inside, and as a result, the cells die. But how does our body react to such a gross invasion? Fortunately, we all have a certain protective mechanisms, named antioxidant protection system.
That's why there are so many talks about vitamins and antioxidants so important for our health, because exactly they protect us rapidly. Moreover, one of the first aid measures in case of chlorine intoxication is taking a high dose of vitamin C inside.
Okay, let's turn back to our Russian soldiers and answer the question, why did Russian combatants look like zombies? We already know that chlorine and hypochlorous acid can react directly with respiratory epithelium braces. All these active forms contribute to further damage of the respiratory tract, swelling, inflammation, spasm of smooth muscles, and dysfunction of the pulmonary vessels. That kind of tissue damage could cause hemorrhaging.
That was one of the reasons Russian soldiers were looking zombie-like in that battle. Truly remarkable is also this person. This is Fritz Haber, German chemist. The first chemical weapon is his brainchild. But being a brilliant scientist, he created two completely different inventions. The first one destroys all the life around, and the other one helps to cultivate living organisms. In addition to leading the teams developing chlorine gas and other deadly gases for use in trench warfare, Haber was on hand personally when it was first released by the German military. For that, Haber was often criticized. However, that was the dark side of his personality, and in 1918, Haber received a Nobel Prize in chemistry, and not for those deadly weapons, but for the invention of the Haber-Bosch process of ammonia synthesis. Today, the total production of fertilizers based on the ammonia synthesis process amounts to more than 100 million tons per year, and the products grown with fertilizers feed now half of the world's population. And his first invention, chemical weapon used for military purposes, is prohibited by the Geneva Convention.
How did you find this story? Is there any other scientists you may know who contributed to the world as much as they destroyed it? You can tell us about it in the comments. And if you have any questions, put them there too. Don't forget to give us a like and subscribe to our channel. Stay tuned. Bye.